gonna start the music here. I'm sure you don't want Zumba. Zumba music?
Oh, music?
No, Zumba. Do you have your lighting system? Hands on your shoulders, bigger circles.
I'm going to Kansas City.
Let's try to know you can use support by the wall.
One finger, you catch.
So I have two options. Option one, you tap with toes, walk in front. Option two, you go around.
Two.
And
Now we're going to move to a pair. Let's go for front calves. 5, 4, 3, 2, narrow. Wide. Narrow. Wide. Narrow. Again. Set. Now let's do the calves. One knee at a time. So the street.
Want to
left. Shoulders are dead and back. Bring your abs in right away. Go deep as you can. And let's go again. Run your thigh or run your calf. Remember option two. You can do knee up, back, and knee up. That's it. Yes, take your time, there's no rush. Four, yeah. Three. And two. You're tired, your legs are tired, march it out. Don't stop moving. Anytime you need water, please have a drink. I should have brought mine right here. We're gonna go back with this one. Bring again your heels together. Contract your glutes. We're gonna add the twist. So shoulders are down, twist in front, and come back. Inhale, exhale to twist. Inhale, exhale, bring the ball in front of you. Keeping your arms open to 180 degrees. Good. Again, feel the work. Brighten your shoulders. Are you still contracting your glutes? Press your big toe to the floor. Press your big toes. You're gonna be more stable. Yeah. And let's go one more time. Do you feel your shoulders? Hello? Am I by myself here?
No.
Yeah. Let's take a drink. We're gonna go back to legs. Well, because we do a lot of lunges and squats, I like to do more side lunges as well. Working in your thighs, but of course we need to work more on your outer thighs. Okay? Ready? You're gonna bend, so my legs are open a lot. I mean, ready for plié. I'm gonna bend my right knee, go up, and switch to the left. So figure eight, between your legs, bend one knee, and then the other one, keeping the chest as high as you can, inhale. Exhale. So notice which way you're going with the ball, with your figure eight. Now switch your figure eight the other way. Oh, you're stuck. I told you, notice which way you're going. Again, for four, three, two, good. Let's stick with the right side. Go with the right, let's go. Four. Whoops. Three. Wait, that's my two. Two. And reverse your circles the other way for four. No, same leg. Linda, same leg. Three.
Gotcha.
Two. Good. Switch it up. Same thing. Let's go. Four. Three. Back. Two. Reverse your circle the other way. Same leg. Four. Three. Two. How many? Two. How many? Oh, okay. And come back. Bring your legs back together. March, 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 march. Okay, keep your legs moving, please. Have water. Just a little break. How are you feeling so far?
It's happening here. Well, we're moving.
Right.
And more. Wow. Bigger muscles we do, more energy you're burning.
See the flames?
Yeah, I know
that. Okay, let's bring again your right leg in front. Shoulders are down and back. I'm gonna give you two options. I want you to squeeze the ball between your shoulder blades. So if you keep your toes on the floor, that's your option one. Option two is if you come in warrior three, keeping the hips square. So you're doing one leg for balance. Pace yourself. Yeah, so looking slightly down, right in front of your foot. Four. Three, nice and slow, Jimmy. Nice and slow. For your arms, don't hurt your shoulders. Good, two more. That's it. And release. March. How many legs do we have?
There you go.
Let's do this one. And then we'll come back to the left. So I just want to test or check if you're awake. Have you had your coffee this morning?
No.
You haven't?
I don't drink coffee before I come here.
I don't either. I don't drink coffee. Trust me, you don't want to see some coffee. Four. Let it fall on your knees. I'm testing your reflex. Catch it back. Keep your eyes on the ball. You have no idea where the ball is going to go. That's the thing. okay? Option two, you're lifting your foot off the floor. Please respect yourself, there's no competition.
Drop or check your shoulders again, make sure you are down and relaxed. That's it. Are you breathing?
She's puffing.
Good. March forward. Push. March. That's it. We have a second leg. So same thing with your left foot. So nice and tall. Step straight back with your left foot. More you're going to bend the front knee, more you're going to feel it at the back. Again, please bring your chair with you, because I want you to keep your shoulders down and back. You know your chair is right there if you need to catch your balance. That's it. Yep, press your heel on the floor. Good job. And push forward and again, gentle march. Let's have a seat. Try not to rest in your back against the chair, using your core. Shoulders are down and back. You're going to bring your right leg up. Point your toes and flex your foot. So point your toes towards your nose. Can you lift the chest even more? What are you feeling here? Where do you feel the work? Yeah, that's a stretch. Where do you feel the work?
Right
in the quads. Feel that? Yeah, because you're getting stronger. Yeah. Again, lift your chest, let's switch your legs, and flex your foot. You can bring your abs into your spine as well. It's going to protect your lower back. Make sure you're flexing your foot. Point your toes towards your nose. Yeah. Breathe. And release, come forward. You're going to cross your right leg over your left. Option one, when you bring your ankle lower than your knee. Option two, higher than your knee. Yeah, you got it. Option three, when you're going to bend your left leg. What are you going to do with your chest? Yeah, what about your shoulders? And what about that?
Breathe.
Well, I know, I want you to know. That's why I want to be in your head.
I was laying on the Chesterfield a couple of months ago, and Gail was sitting in a rocking chair behind me. There was a dog barking outside, and I woke up and I said, Mel! Gail laughed, and I said, oh, Barb has a dog.
And slowly release.
Oh my gosh.
Even in your dreams now?
Very little.
Okay, again, you choose between the three options. Listen to your hips, both are different. Okay? So where do you feel it when you do this one? So your knee should be out. Where do you feel it? Yes, right there. Yeah, that's your piriformis. Again, check your shoulders, nice and tall. Just keep breathing into the stretch.
Poor
her. You see me too often. You see me as much as you see Gail.
I do. I guess so, yeah.
And slowly release. Now you're going to bring your right foot underneath your chair a little bit. I want you to press your heel down the floor. Yeah. So I want you to feel it right here. Do you remember the muscle here?
Yes.
Do you remember how it's called?
What's the name?
Soleus. And then let's open your arms.
Soleus.
For the S-S-O.
Okay.
Yes, soleus. Usually it's tight, and even for myself, it's tight. See, my heel is not completely touching the floor, but I feel it. And slowly release, let's switch your legs. Same thing. So tiny bit on your chair, just enough to be able to press your heel down. Again, option one, you open your arms again, right here, palm facing the middle of the room. Or if you want to go deeper, interlace your fingers together. Open more shoulders and chest. And watch your neck.
Yep, bring it in. Little chin tuck. Breathe. Good. Slowly release your arms, rotate your shoulders backwards. Bring it like that. And let's go to open your hip flexors. Stretch your quads. Gonna give you action again for your arms. If you have problem issues, don't do your arms, just do your legs. Gonna bring your arm up and drop your shoulder. Breathe. Now we're gonna go sideways. Feel the difference in the stretch when you do that. Stretch. And when I inhale up, exhale, bring your arm down. Good rotation. So bring your hand on the outside of your leg, rotate towards your chair, bring your shoulders down. Yeah, that's it. Option alternate.